Hi nerds, hi yogis, welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel and a Nerdy Yogi studio. I'm Carlene Rose, very excited to bring to you your bombshell blast for this week, inspired by Miss Poison Ivy. Typically whenever you see her in any of the pictures and stuff, she's in a pretty standard pinup pose, and I just thought I would use that to inspire us to do some abdominal core side body work. So we will get into that. We'll start, of course, with a quick warm-up. So I am in a comfortable position here on my knees. Make your way to a comfortable seated position. We'll start by inhaling, expanding the low belly, and exhale, squeezing everything in and up out through the nose. Inhaling low. Exhale. Really getting that victorious breath as we exhale. So inhale here, warm and widen all the way through the pelvic bowl, and exhale. Now here we're going to inhale, reach up, and exhale, hands to come to heart center, and we'll twist to the right. Inhale here, exhale, this time twist to the left. Inhale. Twisting from side to side, it's warming up the body. Last time to the right, we'll hold it here for a couple of breaths. Inhale low, exhale, squeeze everything in and out. Inhale, exhale, back to center as we inhale up. And exhale to the left. Again, hold it here a couple of breaths. So inhale, exhale, inhale, last time exhale. Last time inhale to the center, exhale, wave yourself down to kind of a forward fold. We're going to lean forward and come onto our toes for just a moment and sink back into our heels. Give yourself a hug, stretching out the back body. Awesome. Now from here, make your way onto your sits bones. So with these, we want to keep a long spine, even though we'll be doing core work. We don't want to be rounding out our spine or popping out our low back or sacrum or anything. So, grounding into the earth with your sits bones, start with a long spine, and then really lifting in and up through the front low belly to do this core work. Now, I'll show you from the front so you can see it. So, we're going to alternate here. We'll start with our fingertips behind us. We'll do one hip twist. So, you'll start by extending the legs out, rotating onto one hip, and coming onto the side. Kind of a classic pin-up look, if you will. Legs out to the center, rotate onto the left hip, bring the legs in, working the right side body. So we'll alternate with that. We'll do that four rounds, and then we will do a scissor curl on the opposite four rounds. So we'll come to lying down position. Legs will start like a 90 degree, and here again you want neutral. Kind of you want to start with the neutral spine. Then as you exhale and lift your shoulders, you'll notice your low back presses into the earth. And then scissor curls, just alternating like that. So not too terribly difficult, but remember it is a HIIT style workout. This high intensity interval training means we want high intensity while we're doing this. So you'll go all out for 20 seconds, rest for 10 seconds, and then we'll alternate moves. So I've got my Tabata timer going here. So start, ground into the earth with your sits bones, long spine, fingertips behind you. And you can actually use these for support. They're not just to look pretty. Legs out long, come to the right. Legs out long, come to the left. Really exhaling with each move here. Awesome. You can do some cat-cow between. You can just hold it and then make your way to the earth. hold on to your hands, lift elbow or shoulders off the ground, and do scissor curls. Again, really engaging the breath here, using that to help you get through the movement. And here you can stretch out long, hug your knees into your chest, and of course, then rock and roll back up, fingertips behind you, and one hip twist again. And it's totally okay if you get a little tired doing these rounds because we are attacking our side body right now. Awesome, stretch it out here. Sometimes I just like to hold on to my knees and just stretch. Even though we're doing good yoga alignment, you gotta counter pose. And then come onto the earth, shoulders lift, alternating for scissor kicks, for scissor curls. And of course, adjust the pace as needed. You do want it to be challenging, but you don't want it to be so tough that you're not breathing. Obviously, breathing is very important. Nice stretch and rock and roll back up. Fingertips behind you and one hip twist. And if you need to take a moment of rest, you know, before the alarm goes, feel free. You can even stretch out, do some twists real quick here, and make your way back to the earth. The key here first is doing the good alignment. It's not about how fast you can go. Obviously, that's where you get most of the challenge, is by increasing your speed and your intensity, but it's kind of all for naught if the alignment's not there. So start with good alignment, then work your way up to, you know, a faster pace. And if you need to do one or two less rounds, that's totally okay as well. This is your practice. Like I said, you want it to be challenging, but you do also want it to be safe and beneficial for you. Awesome. I wasn't really counting, but I think that was the last one hip twist. All right, this should be our last round here. Knock out your scissor curls with as much intensity as your body will allow, again, in good alignment. Awesome. Woo, that feels good. All right, stretch out your legs long. Your arms and toes reach in opposite direction. You stretch one side out longer than the other. Awesome. And from here, we'll come into kind of a half moon pose lying down. So reach your arms up above you, but walk them over to the right, coming into a side bend, and then walk your feet over, or I'm sorry, to the left, and walk your feet over to the left, stretching out the right side body. Obviously, we just worked it a lot. Remember to breathe here, slow down your heart rate. And walking yourself back to center, this time walking your arms, your hands to the right, and legs then move towards the right, coming into this side body half moon stretch. Awesome, make your way back to center. Stretch again long in all directions. And one last cool down pose. We'll do a therapeutic bridge. So walk your heels up, ground them into the earth, firmly planted. And here, inhale, you're going to inhale your arms above your head. And exhale, try and exhale so that everything hits the earth back at the same time. Inhale here. And exhale. Last time, inhale here. You can hold it for another breath. And exhale. Awesome work today. Take any yogi's choice moment or pose that you might need before coming into your Shavasana final resting pose. Hopefully you are feeling the work and enjoyed that practice. I look forward to seeing you on the mat next week. Make sure that you are subscribed to the channel so that you get the next video, as well as get on the VIP email list. That's some exclusive content for you there. Namaste.